Protect your rights. And what do you want to achieve? What do you want the result to be? How do you get involved to make your society better in politics? What do you do to make better laws in your society? And how about trade with China? Do you have opinions on how you, your country should trade with China? Thank you. 谢谢你们。恭喜。Hello, where are you from?
Tainan.
Huh? Tainan. Tainan. Uh-huh. 今天为什么来？
因为这个服贸议题是大家就是大学生一开始是从学生站立法院，然后导致大家都知道这件事情，大家开始关注这件事。对，然后就这样。
How do you feel when you see so many people gathered together?
我的感想是台湾还是有希望的。Yeah! 我们还是有一个民主，大家还是会关注这个世界，关注这个台湾的未来。
What are your concerns about free trade with China?
我觉得跟中国自由贸易是无可避免，但是也是台湾所需要的。但是这一次的那个跟中国签约的服贸是里面的内容是真的是有点奇怪，就是有点不平等，所以才需要大家来反服贸，让那个服贸能够对台湾会比较平等一点。
Do you think you will participate in politics in your life and try to make your society better through democracy?
应该是不会，因为我之前是一个对社会比较没什么在关注的，对。然后是因为这一次我发在网络上看到一篇文章，就是对大家就是对社会漠视、冷漠，然后没有去关注它，才导致一些事情的发生。所以我才之后应该虽然是不会参加什么政治，但是对于社会的议题应该会多多
比以前关心、啊、
对，会比以前关心。
How does a person in Taiwan influence their government? What is your method for making your government better?
关于这件事，我们现在所在的地方，这个时间点所在的地方，就是为了影响政府对人民做更有利的事情。
All right, can you tell me where you're from?
Penghu.
Penghu? But you came from Penghu? From like Magong or?
Qiyu.
Oh, Qiyu. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, okay. But why did you come to Taipei?
今天
为什么？
今天就是来参加看很多支持反，就是反服贸，反对服贸。
What do you hope to accomplish at the demonstration? What do you hope will happen?
希望马总统可以正面，而且很有善意的，知道自己问题的来回答学生的诉求。
Penghu is reliant on tourism, and if we have free trade with China, won't there be more tourists from China coming to Penghu?
对，没有错，游客会增加。而增加的是所谓的中国游客，这不止澎湖的问题，整个台湾，好像去年来台湾旅游的人数是800万人。好，那我们看一个例子，叫香港。香港去年去香港入境的中国游客，大家猜猜看是多少？
多少？
你绝对猜不到。
1000万。
800。
错。
2000万。更多。
台湾是全世界来台湾玩的人是800万，一年800万。香港，你猜是多少人？
1800万。
当你看到那个数字，我是吓死，叫惊吓。7000万。
七千万。
而且有7000万，而且在一年或两年之内，估计就会超过1亿。好，你想想看，我们不用到1亿。如果是7000万的旅客到台湾现在的旅游市场，你想会发生什么样的事情？那是非常非常从头到尾，就是经济上、文化上、产业上，跟你的生活上都会产生巨变，叫 Titanic 的巨已经不能够形容，非常大的冲击，这个是要想清楚的。
可是他们一般的现在这些国民党那些人啊，他们会认为说，哎，这样很好啊，可以招来游客啊。可是，
所以我们可以讨论嘛，好，没关系，好就好啊。但我觉得我有我的顾虑啊，那可以讨论吗？
那你的顾虑是什么？
我提到的，一年如果有7000万的游客到台湾来旅游，你这个市场你要怎么处理它？从头到尾你要怎么处理它？还有从生活、从产业、从文化、从生态上，你要怎么去处理这个这么大的问题？没有人在讨论这件事情啊，你就一定要让它过啊。你说很好没有关系嘛，很多人也觉得很好，有钱赚有什么不好？可是我们可以谈吗？我们可以谈吗？马英九的态度是不能谈，三个字不能谈。昨天他也提到了。不能把服贸退回去，就是不能谈。那不能谈这件事情要怎么办？
他会不会堵你说你讲的那些问题，我们都会处理啊？他只是没讲。
他让我们了解啊，我不了解。
没有，我们知道你有没有处理嘛？因为那个你服贸条款就放在网络上了。我们这几天已经大家都在堵啦，各式各样产业的人都有在帮你在堵这件事情。你说你以为这个世界还是那个马英九才读得懂的法律条文吗？不是啊。我们识字，我们会看书，而且我们看了12天的书，对啊，我们不是不了解这个问题，是你应该马先生应该出来面对问题，而且他不正面来面对这样的问题，他只讲一件事情，钱会赚到钱，而且我们很怀疑的，如果大陆你站在中国的立场上，你有7000万的游客掌握在你手上，钱谁会赚得到？这个如果问我小学3年级的女儿，她也会跟我回答。一定是有钱的人赚得到的，那有，而且他掌握着旅客7000万哎，像这看起来像是数学，可是那一个一个人点人头，我们今天这么多人才21万哎，7000万哎，你说那个钱你赚得到吗？绝对不是，跟我在座这一群人，没有任何一个人赚得到钱。
Many people in Europe and North America are concerned that democracy everywhere is eroded. The problem is inequalities in society. And people disengage from politics because they feel it's dirty. In Taiwan, politics is dirty. So how can we have a good democracy in a society where the politics are like this? What do you think?
这个要牵扯到另外一个问题，叫结构的问题，就是人口结构跟政治生态的问题。这有时候是在台湾来讲是无解的，是无解。但是我们必须要去努力，不是更大的一个聚会，不是，是大家去想这件事情，就是把问题提出来，我们大家一起来想这件事情。就更多人，因为现在很多人其实还是不关心这个议题的，对，还是不关心这个议题。如果更多人参与，更多人知道，比如说像这样的人。大家一起来，对，开启对话的可能，改变我们自己内部，我们自己把自己的问题解决清楚，我们才有办法去面对中国这么大的一个对手。
Free trade is a danger to your environment? What about people who think that free trade increases wealth in the society?
Thank you.这个文化会大量会流失，这种自由贸易经济这方面，如果传统文化会有资本主义进入的话
，Is he suggesting that there might be something more important than wealth and trade？
Yeah， 对对，比金钱更
重要。当
然，对，环境最重要。
谢谢你。
钱可以再赚，那这个东西没办法回来。
So， what do you want to accomplish here？
就是要退回福茂，要先立法，然后再审。
They want to just return the contract with China.
我们还要立法。
And they want to make the legislation for the monitoring the government.
Don't you think trade will increase wealth in the society and give people better jobs?
No, I don't think so. Because only the rich people can make a lot of money, but. 不晓得怎么讲，其他的人就是会赚不到钱。比如说像一些一般的老百姓，其实赚不到多少钱的，可以吗
？So there is something more important than wealth and trade?
Yes, of course.
What is more important than wealth and trade?
因为有些东西是金钱换不到的，比如说像我们的一些文化方面的。因为金钱其实没有办法给我们所有的快乐。如果说我们所有的东西都只能用物质来换的话，那你知道我们就不需要考虑感情那种事情。如果我们一味只重视经济的话，那我们其他的就是我们情感或者是我们的道德或者是我们的文化，就是是怎样都要舍弃了吗？如果我们只重视经济的话，
对。Is that okay?
Yeah, very good. 谢谢你。
Taiwan.
Yeah, I see. These are all the Minjingdang or the DPP. Yeah. So the Kuomintang representatives aren't depicted by themselves. It's just a picture of the president.
Yes, because they are just like they follow what the president say. So they are just like their president.
Mm-hmm.
No, our president.
Yeah, you have strong party discipline in the Kuomintang, and mm-hmm. He is definitely telling them what to do.
Mm-hmm.
So it's 43 DPP members in the 117 in the whole?
I think so, 43.
Well, that's Lee Teng-hui's party. He was the president 20 years ago or whatever.
Yeah. Almost 20.
Yeah. This is where they take their naps and mm-hmm. sleep at night?
Yeah. They will dim the light,
mm-hmm.
like after midnight, I guess. And some they take turns taking naps.
The maps have signatures on them, right?
Mm-hmm. These three, all of them are from Hong Kong, different universities. Hong Kong Chinese University or Hong Kong...
Hong Kong Polytechnic?
Yeah, 1, 2, 3.
Signed by students from Hong Kong Polytechnic.
Yes.
Good for them. Question about civil society.
Yes.
I understand that Taiwan doesn't have a lot of nonprofit organizations that do political advocacy outside of your dominant two-party system, right? For example, you have a Ming Jingdang, or a DPP as they're called, and the Gold Mingdang, the ruling party.
Yes.
And they dominate political efforts in this country. You maybe have an anti-nuclear movement, you maybe have an Aboriginal rights movement, but you don't really have a strong civil liberties movement like we have in America. You don't have an environmental movement with strong political pressure groups. I'm not sure that you have any kind of like good government citizens committees that are nonpartisan or bipartisan. Could you explain to me what kind of civil society you have outside of the two-party system in Taiwan?
I think recently there are a lot of civil society or civil groups trying to do some nonpartisan movements like anti-monopoly of media. Do you know that?
Yes.
It happens last year, and the wild strawberry movement is also.
What is the wild strawberry movement?
It's a movement. Wild strawberry movement is a movement organized by students, and they protest against what kind of protest?
About our national flag forbidden to use when Chinese officials came to visit in Taiwan.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yes. We
thought we could wave our flags and protest against the Chinese.
It was in 08 when Chen Yunling came.
Yeah.
Right. You had to hide all the Taiwan flags.
We're not allowed.
We're forbidden to show it any.
In everywhere the Chen Yunling may go through.
What are some of the other activities that civil society are concerned about in Taiwan? For example, I mentioned already the nuclear power and Aboriginal rights.
Yeah. Also the press, the freedom to press.
The freedom of the press?
Yeah, the anti-monopoly of media.
Yeah.
We are against a China-funded corporation trying to absorb some Taiwanese media company. Mm-hmm. And as well, this time, Sunflower Movement is, I think it's going to be a milestone of this kind of nonpartisan student movement, because it is its core request or core demands is to ask the government to abide to comply with the constitutional law, to apply with the procedural requirement to pass a trade agreement with China. It is nonpartisan because of it neither accepts the DDP's DDP's funding or DDP's support or DDP's any kind of the partisan support. Mm-hmm. And also it appeal to the KMT party members to join our movement. We are welcome to all parties and not only to address the KMT only. And as well, this is a nonpartisan movement because this issue is about the political or something. It's about the law. Why? Because when the passage of the trade agreement is happened in 18th March, and everyone's just angry and break into here. And we occupy here for like 3,090 hours.
Instant update the record. And so we have already occupied here for 15 days, and it's going to the 16th day.
So it is not about which party is although the Mao government is from KMT party, and this Congress has met you can come here and see this. There's a lot of party members, a lot of congressmen or congresswomen are KMT party's representative. But we don't only put them on there. We also put the KMT and put the DDP parties and also the minority parties.
The red symbol means they support you, and the black symbol means they support the trade treaty as it is, or
no? The The red one is lucky, and the bad one is the unfortunate. It means that if you don't join our the passage of the oversight law, do you know that oversight law?
That's what you're asking for, is a change in the law so there's a more oversight in any treaties or trade with China.
Not to change the law, but to create and to draft a new law to oversee every agreement signed with China. So if the KMT party members join the signature or to join the passage, they respond to our appeal, they will become red one and the lucky one. And so far, there are no KMT party members.
Do you have a question mark for one of them? Right there, Wang Jingping.
He's now in a political conflict with the President Ma, and President Ma has a strong party weak to his own party members. So now he's on a question mark because his position is uncertain. And we don't know. He's for a poor. He's pro or con this.
After this movement is finished, what do you think the students who participated will do to foster a more democratic society in Taiwan?
I think this is an example shows that the students are mature enough to participate in any public deliberation and public movement. Because you see, everything is well organized. It's non-violence and peaceful appeal to the government, and we don't have any troubles. And so far, it has been 2 weeks, and it caused no damages or no casualties. So I think it's a miracle. So far, like Ukraine or other movements of democracy, there are a lot of people dying or get hurt. But this time in Taiwan, only the government do something wrong to hurt people. When the students and civilians storm into the government headquarters, executive yuan, at the night of the 24th March.
Yeah, that's Sunday night. Yeah.
Yeah. Then the riot police just use batons and cannon waters to strike people down. And it is I don't know because CNN reports also says that it's a Taipei Tiananmen event. It's terrible because I a lot of people got hurt, and some of them are seriously injured. So it's a bloody night, I think. And except that, there's no bloodshed outside the HQ, the government HQ. So I think it's so proud to be part of this movement.
So let me reflect back what I've heard you say.
Yeah.
I asked you how you thought this would help the students, or what the students would do after this movement to create a democratic society, and you have pointed out that this movement has shown that students can be engaged and there's no risk. It's peaceful.
Yes.
The students are showing that they're mature.
Yeah.
And you are, I think, implying that this will be an inspiration to young people to get more involved in making a more democratic society.
Exactly. I think there will be more and more young people to join the political movement or the civil the civil rights advocates outside or inside the existed NGO groups or human rights groups. There are a lot of human rights groups, and they are sort of nonpartisan, but they basically would not cooperate with the KMT. So you can call them as gray or the non-blue color. But yep.